Apple recently revealed one of their most highly anticipated products ever, the Apple Vision Pro, which introduces a new way to interact with digital content that the company calls spatial computing. Instead of tapping or clicking on a display, users look through it, merging their digital and physical life for the first time ever. The product itself features a modular design, held together by magnets. It's comprised of a glass and aluminum enclosure, a breathable headband, and a soft fabric seal to block out light. The part housing most of the technology is the glass and aluminum enclosure. On top is a digital crown similar to those found on Apple Watch and AirPods Max, which dials the virtual environment in or out, and recenters any virtual screens when pressed. There's also a shutter button which is used to quickly take photos or video. Inside the device are 23 sensors, including 4 inward IR cameras and inward LED illuminators to precisely track your eye movement, and 2 main cameras, 4 downward cameras, 6 microphones, 2 external IR illuminators, 2 side cameras, a LiDAR scanner, and a true depth camera to track your hands and environment. The information from these sensors is fed into a new R1 chip, which helps the system reduce lag by streaming new images to the display in less than 12 milliseconds, or 8 times faster than the blink of an eye, preventing motion sickness for most users. There's also a computer-grade M2 chip, the same one found in MacBook Air, which powers the Vision operating system, algorithms, and graphics. The 2 internal displays responsible for delivering a photorealistic environment are the size of a postage stamp, containing 11.5 million pixels each. This is made possible by a new display technology called Micro OLED, which fits 64 pixels in the space of a single iPhone pixel, for a total of 23 million pixels across both displays, which is more than a 4K TV for each eye. On top of each display is a 3-element lens designed to magnify the panels and wrap them around you, resulting in a display that's everywhere you look. For those needing prescription lenses, Apple's partnering with Zeiss to deliver custom inserts. Since Apple arranged all the sensors around the perimeter of the device, there was space in the center for an outward-facing display, allowing Apple to solve one of the biggest problems with computational headsets: isolation. Instead of being disconnected from those around you, Vision Pro shares where your attention's at. If you're in an immersive environment, onlookers will see this graphic. But if your attention turns to someone in your real environment, the graphic will fade out to reveal your eyes, displaying a live feed of your eye position, movement, and blinks, allowing for natural, spontaneous interactions not possible on any other headset. This is accomplished with a curved lenticular display, the first of its kind, which is essentially a digital version of a lenticular print that reveals different images depending on the viewing angle. So multiple people looking at different angles are all shown the correct perspective of your face. The straps attached to the enclosure are made from a similar flexible polyurethane as an Apple Watch band, and contain built-in audio pods on either side. The dual drivers are equipped with a new spatial audio system, which utilizes audio ray tracing to analyze the features and materials of your room, allowing sound to be placed in your surroundings more accurately than ever. On the headband, you'll find the fit dial, which tightens or loosens the device. But what does Apple Vision Pro actually do? Well, after putting it on, you'll simply see a live feed of your surroundings, and in a fraction of a second, your iris is automatically scanned for identification, something called Optic ID, which is even more secure than Face ID. Then you're welcomed by a grid of circular icons. But how do you navigate this interface? Well, rather than using a cursor or reaching out with a finger, you simply look with your eyes. As you glance from one icon to another, they respond with an animation. To make a selection, just tap your fingers. Thanks to the downward cameras, you don't have to lift your hand to make this gesture. To enter text, just look at a text field and start speaking. Windows can be moved, pushed back, pulled closer, and scaled, all while reacting to the lighting in your room and casting shadows. But if you'd prefer to be somewhere else, just choose an immersive environment and turn the digital crown to dial in your new space. Here, you can use familiar apps like Safari, Messages, and Notes. If someone approaches, you'll see them subtly fade into view. Type with a virtual keyboard or connect a physical Bluetooth keyboard and trackpad. And if you have a MacBook, just open it and watch its contents seamlessly transition into Apple Vision Pro, giving you a huge, private, portable 4K display. But what about using FaceTime when half your face is covered? Well, Apple created a solution called Personas. By scanning your face, a machine learning algorithm creates a 3D model of yourself and displays it to others on the call. In the Photos app, selecting a photo or video automatically dims the room, and panoramas taken on iPhone can expand and wrap around you, giving you the same life-size experience as when it was taken. But perhaps one of the most compelling use cases of Apple Vision Pro is watching 3D movies, since you can play them on theater-sized screens and experience 3D depth effects in a way never possible before. All these technologies and capabilities come at a cost of $3,500 and will be available in the US only starting early 2024. Now, that is a high price that needs context. The original Macintosh, released in 1984, cost $2,500, which is $7,300 today, twice as much as Apple Vision Pro. And the jump in technology from the Apple Lisa to the Macintosh was arguably not as dramatic as the jump from today's Mac to Apple Vision Pro. Also, consider the Varo XR3 headset at $6,500, which doesn't even have the technologies and hardware to match Apple Vision Pro's performance. So that's everything new with Apple Vision Pro. This is Greg with Apple Explained. Thanks for watching till the end, and I'll see you in the next video.